Friday, the 15th of July. Tomorrow, the 16th, is round 5 of the UK Tower Attack Championship at Alton Park. It's been 4 weeks since rounds 3 and 4 at Rantach. The car's gone through quite a big transformation, as I hope you've all been watching and following along. Now, we didn't get the entire debrief list from Rantach complete. Difficulty is trying to balance finding time to work on the car, but also finding time to fabricate all your orders, which earns us money to allow us to go racing. So it's been difficult. There's been a lot of long days and late nights trying to get it done, but we've got as much done as we needed to. Obviously, we fixed the ride height issue, so hopefully the car's going to handle a lot better at Alton Park tomorrow. So today I've decided not doing any work. I want to leave here quite early to get to Alton Park. I want to try and get there for 4 o'clock, just so we can sort of like chill, watch some car goes around the track, have a couple of drinks, and just catch up with everyone really. Because at Rantach we didn't get there until like 10 o'clock at night, so it'd be nice to have a leisurely drive down this afternoon with no stress. So we're just heading to the workshop now. We're going to pull the van from down the side of the workshop. We'll just make sure we've got all the gear on board, the toolbox, the welder, load all that up. We'll turn the fridge on, get some bevvies in there. Then we'll go fetch the trailer. And then I'm hoping we're going to get the car on the dyno this morning. I really want to calibrate the speedo so I know how fast I'm going. The only thing about the carbon catalyst is it doesn't give you a speed indicator, whereas last year the solo lap timer did. And maybe while it's on the dyno, we might just do a power run and just do a quick health check to make sure the engine's not knocking. And you know, we're still curious to what power it's making, because you know, we, after all the fiddling at Rantach, we still don't know what power it's making. So that's going to be today's business. Get a bit of shopping done and hopefully have a nice little time lapse driving to Alton Park. So let's get at it. Right, so I didn't film any of it, but we've got most of the livery on now. I made the decision not to put the blue stripes back on. I think the all black look makes it look real serious and real tough. Obviously, our biggest sponsor, Howtech, we've got them on the doors in pride place. I've just got one more sticker to put down here, which is the Artech sticker, which is coming this morning. I've still got Bill B. Then we have Bill, Alexi at Thunderwood, Doug at G19. We've also picked up a little Turbo Smart sponsorship. I need to do a video on that when we finally install the part. Aiden Vivid does most of our stickers. ICB do a lot of laser cutting. Newton, which does a lot of flags and banners. And then Rusky, who's a lot of carbon work. We've also put the front splitter and air dam back on. Obviously, the number plate needs to come off. We repaired the damage that we got from Donington last year. We just bent the brackets up, so we've just put a couple of washers in there to level out the blade again. So, but unfortunately, it's got to come off again to go on the dyno and to get it on the trailer. So it's a bit of a fuck about putting it on and off all the time, but we've got to do it. So. So a couple of dyno runs and we've settled at the moment anyway, 201.7 horsepower, roughly 170 foot-pounds of torque, so I think that'll do for this weekend. At least not blow it up anyway. So another dyno run later, and we're now at 220 horsepower and 190 foot-pounds ish. I think that'd be plenty enough for this weekend, because I don't really want to be replacing an engine before we go. So I think that'll do. We'll get loaded, and then we'll head off to Alton Park. And there we go, that's the car all loaded, we're good to go. We've just had the last of the sponsor stickers for Artec. I still need to do a video on that, because I don't think we actually formally announced it on the video, but yeah, they're a big part of what we're doing this year as well. So yeah, we're loaded. It's 20 past 12 and we're gonna start heading to Alton Park. We have made it to Alton Park. a longer drive than expected. You'll have seen in that sort of bit of a B-roll just there was in plenty of traffic jams, so it turned a 3.5 hour drive into 4.5 hours, longer than I would have liked. But anyway, we're here now, we're all set up, we've got a garage, quite happy with this garage because we're next door to toilets, which makes a change because usually we've got to walk all the way down there to go for a piss or a shit. But yeah, we've got the Micra in the garage. We've got all our gear set up down here. So the guys from Howtech UK, Mark and Luke, that have been helping with the Micra, got bitten by the bug. I actually offered them the red Civic that we built to borrow as much as they'd like, but they've actually been out and bought their own car. So I believe it's an EK4 VTI, so it's got the stock B16A2. I think they've 170 horsepower. But yeah, I'm really excited to actually enter this as a team now. It's always been the goal to enter, you know, as a team of friends. So yeah, we're really looking forward to how we both get on. Plus, it's a nice bit of rivalry, which is nice. It gets you going throughout the day. But yeah, we've got the Micra there. We've got the splitter back on. As we had to take the splitter off for the dyno and get it on a trailer, because obviously now we're 60 mil lower. It doesn't go on a trailer anymore with a splitter. But yeah, we should be all good for scrutiny in the morning. However, I've just realised that I forgot to put the Pirelli stickers on the front bumper, so I'm going to have to get them stickers in the morning. And luckily for us, the stickers are literally just next door, so should be golden. Now, we was going to walk the track, but the temperature is dropping. It's quite cold now, and it's actually meant to be the start of the Britain's heat wave.
You.
Up to 35 degrees, so tomorrow's looking a bit hot. We'll see how we go along. To compensate for this heat, if it comes, we've actually put some thicker Miller's Motorsport spec oil in it to hopefully combat oil pressure and oil temperatures. But I've also been out and bought a big fan, so as soon as the car comes in the garage, we can stick the fan in front of it and get it cooled down reasonably quick. One thing we struggled with at Brown Tax is after coming in, the coolant temperature spiked quite quickly, quite worryingly quick. So hopefully as soon as you come in, Dad's going to put the fan in front of the car and hopefully we'll get the temperatures under control so we don't spew a head gasket. So yeah, that's it for this portion of the vlog, and yeah, we'll continue in the morning. So good morning, I'm awake, a bit of a panic state. We've just gone scrutineering. I just sat idling, the car started knocking, so let me just start the engine and just sort of show you what the engine sounds like. So we thought the engine was cunted, and it turns out that the auxiliary belts come off and it's slapping against the timing case, so engine's not dead, which is a good thing. So yeah, I started the vlog a bit late, so hopefully we're gonna fix that and get back out for the first session. Sorry, I'm just panicking because I need to get this car done. Thank you. Right, so that's the first section done and out of the way. A few teething issues from that section is we've upped the boost, but we haven't upped the boost cut. So we're just constantly hitting boost cut all the way around. And it has a 1 second delay to reset itself. So literally just kangarooing all the way around the circuit. Realised that partial throttle was the way to go. Managed to do a couple laps of partial throttle and we got a 151. So that's 2 seconds slower than last year. Last year was 149. So my obsessive rambling before that section is we was parked in scrutineering. Just sat there riding away and all of a sudden the engine started ticking and it sounded like a bit like a top end knock. Of course my heart sank. Long story short, the auxiliary belt and shat itself because Muggins here had not tightened up the idler pulley, so that's all back together. New belt on, she's mint. Other issue we had is we've got a real violent vibration from the passenger rear. Can't find anything obvious other than the tyre is really got a load of shit on it, so we've swapped the tyres left and right to see if the vibration moves to the other side of the car. But other than that, absolute rocket ship. So we're not long for going out for our second session. So one thing I forgot to mention is we were hitting 19 psi of boost, and so we've brought the boost back down to 17 psi and then we've upped the boost up to 20 psi and hopefully that will solve at least get us around a couple of laps in the next session. So here's the footage from session two.
Now, as we discussed earlier on this morning, there are no points.
Right, so that was interesting. We did maybe 6-7 laps until we had to come off for the first couple laps, which will be this clip here. Oh. The brakes failed. Pedal went straight to floor and I had to abort and go down towards Shell Oil's corner. Had to abort down there. Did a couple laps after that and the brakes are just gone. So we had to double pump the brakes into the corner just to get some forward pedal to slow us down. Then come around Islands, back over the crest, went to change gear and I put my foot to the floor. Engine wasn't going anywhere. Took my foot off the pedal and I noticed that the revs were still climbing. Straight away, I knew we had an engine runaway. So pulled off the side and then got stuck out there for half hour until they eventually pulled me back in. So I'm not best pleased about that, but we're here now. We've took the bonnet off and my suspicions were confirmed. We have gone full danger to manifold.
You're lucky that 100 shot of NOS didn't blow the welds on the intake.
So luckily we have the Artec Weld mobile fabrication station with aluminium welding capabilities, so we're gonna weld it in situ. Bit risky. We've had to remove the splitter because we've worn through a couple of bolts and basically it's flapping around in the wind and we were getting black flag for it. Luckily we didn't get a black flag because we didn't complete that lap that was gonna black flag us on. So yeah, we're gonna repair the inlet manifold in situ and hopefully we've got about an hour and a half to get back out. Shouldn't be too long of a repair hopefully, but hopefully we should be able to get back out and then at least try and bleed the brakes again because the brakes are just absolutely shot. I mean, you can see by the discs, we're just overheating the brakes. So yeah, let's get this welded up and then we'll get out for the next session. Alright, so we've welded up the inlet manifold, did it in situ. Hopefully there's some footage that we hear filmed by this man. Or someone's hopefully filmed it. And then we're still trying to chase this vibration on the rear, so we've swapped the wheel bearings left to right. Let's see how that changes things. So yeah, we're out now in about, I think, half hour. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah, hope some footage of the next session. And that'll be this footage now. So we're back here from our third session. Micro is still alive. I did a 1:43.09, but the lap time was disallowed because of track limits, which will be hopefully this clip here. So a bit of an issue with that session is I don't believe this recorded the footage for whatever reason. I've got some snippets of footage. Hopefully I found some footage by the time I get back and edit this video. So I can't really show you anything, I don't think. But yeah, we had an optimal of a 142.12, which is nice. Now, basically, we've got no brakes. The brakes just can't cope. We've got an issue somewhere. We've re-bled the brakes with some Castrol SRF. I mean, if you know that stuff, it's expensive. So I'm having to brake really early to get at least two or three pumps in the pedal to get some confidence that the car's going to stop. But once I've got some brakes that I'm happy with, that I know are going to stop, I'm pretty happy. Pretty sure that around here there's going to be a sub 140 in this little Micra, so that's, you know, that's impressive. The vibration issue, we found out what it was. So I've done all that work to make sure the tyre doesn't impact the rear tubs, and also the clearance in the front arches by having them carbon fibre arches. It's actually now in the front wheel is now impacting the inner wheel arch. I'll probably edit the clip in from the debrief when it's in the ramp, but it's impacting the arch. In fact, you can see it, look, it's got some heat marks here, so the tyre's hitting this arch underneath. So we could get a hammer out and get some clearance in there, but I really don't want to hack that part of the car up. So you can sort of see here it's wearing down the centre of the tyre. So I think what we're going to do is we're just going to persevere. Now we know what it is, and we know it's not doing any sort of massive damage, we'll happily go out there again with it as it is, and then we will rectify it before donning. So providing the Garmin works and record some footage, hopefully you're going to have some footage of the final session. So here's that footage now. So that was a fucking hot one. I am sweltering. On a plus note, we've just set our PB, a 140.176, and I'm fucking dead shit for that. Optimal again, 140.121, although I'm pretty sure we had a delta 0.8 seconds quicker than that, so that would have been a 140. So a 140.176 puts us in the slightly midfield of the pack, and a car with no brakes. So just to give you an idea of how bad the brakes are, I'm having to brake really early and triple pump the brakes, and even then the pedal wants to go to the floor just to get the car to stop. So I think that sort of time, considering the how hurt the car is and how we've got no brakes, I'm pretty confident to say there will be the sub 140 in this car in its current condition with working brakes. We toned the boost down a bit so we don't blow the inner manifold open again, so there's more boost with brakes that'll stop the car, you know, round Alton Park sub 140, but we're not going to know until next year. But yeah, I'm just going to summarize up today. That's it really. We're packing up, going home. I'd like to thank obviously all the sponsors, Haltech, Mark and Luke, which are over there, Artec to the mobile fabrication station, which is currently being loaded in the van. That definitely saved our day today. In fact, I'm probably going to ring Artec up on Monday, speak to Daz, who he dealt with, to sort out the station, and just give him a personal thank you, really. So it really has saved our day. The manifold will go over in the debrief video, which will be out a couple of days after this. So on that note, I'm not actually going to stay anymore. I'm going to save all of my stuff I've got to save for the debrief video in a couple of days. So yeah, thanks for watching another Time Attack vlog, and we'll see you in the next video very shortly. About 6 weeks to round 6 at Donington, so looking forward to that. So we'll see you then. Ciao for now.